everywhere you go. Take a look in the 5 and 10, glistening once again, with candy canes and silver lanes aglow.
Hi folks, today I'm going to be showing you how I made this festive garland using snowflake pom-poms and some different coloured bells. And of course the most important part of this project is making the pom-poms themselves. So I'm going to show you step by step how I used some yarn and cardboard templates to make these snowflake pom-poms. So let's get started. But I have to tell you that just yesterday I was a complete novice at making pom-poms. I'd never done it before. And this was my first attempt. This was my second attempt. But after a couple more attempts, I had improved my game. Look at those. So if your first attempt comes out looking like one of these, it's fine. I will offer you a couple of tips that I found helped me. And both this one and this one were made using the same size template. So it's nothing to do with the template size. It's to do with how much yarn you wrap around. So you're going to need a lot more yarn than you might initially think. I'm using white so that they look like snowflakes, but of course you could use any colour you fancy. And you'll need some scissors. If you've got one of our art packs, because you're helping us to decorate a tree in Moseley Park, you'll already have some of these cardboard templates. But if you don't, I'll show you how to make those templates today. You'll need some cardboard, and I'm using a lid from this tea box. You'll need your scissors. You'll need two round things to draw around. So I've got this tumbler, and I've got a penny coin. You can use any coin from a penny up to a pound, or even a £2. And of course something to draw around those things, so you can use a pencil or a pen. When we come to assembling the garland, I'm going to use some of these bells. I've got different sizes here. I've got these big rusty bells, and these little colourful ones. And I've also got some rustic looking stars here. But that's for later. So now let's get on to making our cardboard templates. If you've already got some, you can use those. And then we'll make the pom-poms. Okay, so the first step to make our cardboard templates, take glass or some other round thing. Draw around it. So this is roughly how big your pom-pom is going to be. Okay. So two identical circles. And then we need a smaller circle inside them. So I'm using this penny. Just pop it in the middle of the circle. And draw around it in the same way. It's not like you have to measure it so that it's exactly centre. You can just go by eye. Okay, and again the next bit that we'll do just by eye is to do a little segment there. You see what I've done there? And we can do the same on the other, or what we can do is cut this one out and then use that as a template to cut that one out. So, get our scissors, and I'm just going to cut this out. It's important that the two circles are the same size as one another, but if you feel like you've cut a bit of a jaggedy circle around the edges, that's going to be okay. All right. So now we have our two templates. Next we're going to take our yarn, and this is the fun bit. Although it is a little bit time consuming. I found that once I got going, it was taking me about 10 to 15 minutes to make each pom-pom. So if you want to make lots of pom-poms, you need to factor that in as the kind of time scale. Of course, you might be able to do it faster than me, or you might take a little bit longer. And that's just how long I found that it took. Okay, I'm going to start somewhere kind of near this edge here. Just start winding the yarn around. It's okay if you don't get the yarn right up to the very edges of the cardboard. Just get it as close to each edge as you can.
Take a look in the 5 and 10, glistening once again.
It's starting to look a bit like a croissant. We want to really fatten it up. Santa is fat and so will our pom-poms be. So we are going to be decorating a tree on the 29th of November. If you've volunteered to help us do that and to make these decorations for the tree, you will have in your kits already everything that you need to make the garlands. If you find that you don't manage to make lots and lots of pom-poms, if you just make one or two, you can absolutely just give us whatever you've managed to do so far. Please don't feel that if it's not completely as finished as you'd have liked it to be, that it's not useful. It still will be. Alright. So now I've got a nice fat croissant shape. And the next thing, this is a little bit fiddly, is to part the cardboard, these two pieces of cardboard, and slide the scissors in between the two bits of cardboard. Stick your thumb in the middle, and then that will allow you to keep hold of the yarn that you're cutting into. Okay, let's go. And you see, it already starts to pom-pom outwards. If you need to adjust, you can turn your thumb around the other way and start cutting down the other side. If you have to sacrifice a bit of cardboard as well, not the end of the world. Alright, so now we have what looks a lot like a nice fluffy pom-pom. I'm just going to put that down. We're going to take some more yarn. Enough to wrap around your pom-pom loosely. So, about that much. Fold it in two. Now, separating the bits of cardboard, we're going to put this yarn in between the pieces of cardboard, like so, and I'm going to wrap it all the way around inside the two bits of cardboard, and then we tie a knot and we pull this knot as tight as we can, really squeeze. Good. Now we wrap it around again on the inside of the cardboard. Move the little bits of pom-pom out of the way if you need to. Tighten a knot again. Give it a real squeeze. Make sure that this loop stays kind of longer than the rest of the strands, because you don't want to lose the loop. Okay. And now, all we do is slide the cardboard off. Now we've got a big old fluffy pom-pom with its loop just there. Now that is a fairly rustic looking pom-pom. It's quite straggly in places, And I'm okay with that. You might choose to leave yours kind of looking a little bit rustic and irregular. Or you can trim some of the straggly ends off if you see that some are distinctly longer than others. And one way of doing that is to flatten the pom-pom down as much as you can. Flatten it down. And then, with it flat like that, I can more easily see where the longer bits are. You see there's some there. I'm just going to snip off. It might actually be easier to do that with it on the table like that. And some people go around the whole thing, snip, snip, snipping, because that gives more of a like a tight puffball effect. I'm not going to do that. I'm only going to trim off the bits that are sort of noticeably longer than others. Okay. So we can sort of puff it out. Trim bits if we want to, but we don't have to. And there we have it. A beautiful snowflake-like pom-pom. So now to assemble my garland, all I'm doing is taking a piece of yarn the length that I want my garland to be. And you could double it up. I think I'm going to go with just a single strand of yarn because it is quite strong. I'm just going to start threading the pom-poms on. And then once we've threaded it on, we go back through that same loop with the long piece of yarn and tie a knot around the loop that the pom-pom has so that pom-pom is now going nowhere. I'm going to take one of these giant belts, slide it onto the yarn, about as far along as I want it to be, a little bit further, ooh, not that far, and then again, we go back through, thread it through. And then again, we tie a knot. Okay. And so here is my finished garland with lots of pom-pom snowflakes and different coloured bells. I'm pretty pleased with this. Considering that yesterday I'd literally never made a pom-pom before, and you saw the scraggy first couple of attempts that I made, and then I progressed on to nice round pom-poms like these. And so this is going to be hung in Moseley Park on the 29th of November, which is coming up soon, and those of you who've already volunteered to take part, you will have your kits by now. If you haven't already got them, they'll be on their way very soon to you. And so you can make your own snowflake pom-poms. As I said earlier, if you don't manage to assemble a whole garland and you just make a few pom-poms or even just one pom-pom, you're very, very welcome just to give us what you have done and we will find a place for it on the tree. Okay? Look forward to seeing you again soon. Bye for now.